A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6th July. So today the newspaper covers the budget. Budget was announced on 5th July. So here is the step-by-step detail about the budget. The finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman, who was former defense minister, this is her first budget and it's all about incremental measures. So here you can see what steps have been taken. One is Aadhaar can be interchanged with PAN to file IT returns. Second, 70,000 crore to be infused into public sector banks. Those earning 2 crore to 5 crore will pay 3% and 7% surcharge. So the surcharge percentage has been increased. With low external debt now, government to start borrowing abroad. So this has been announced. Here you can see in taxation, GST on electric vehicles have been cut to 5% now. Additional income tax deduction of 1.5 lakh on interest on loans taken to buy electric vehicles has also been announced. Custom duty on gold and other precious metals has been increased from 10% to 12.5%. And PVCs and auto parts, polyvinyl chloride PVC material which is used in auto parts, for them the duty has been hiked, and also the duty has been imposed on newsprint. Then excise duty on fuel has been hiked by 1 rupee. TDS, tax deduction at source, of 2% imposed on cash withdrawals exceeding 1 crore in a year from bank accounts as such. So this has been announced to discourage business payments in cash. 2% TDS will be imposed. Also, threshold for applicability of lower corporate tax rate of 25% has been increased. So corporate tax rate of 25% will be applied for those with annual turnover of 400 crore. Earlier it was 250 crore. So more people would be benefited by this lower corporate tax rate, more companies. Then these are taxation related changes. In social sector, pension benefit has been extended to 3 crore retail traders. Then 60% of amount received by subscribers of national pension system on closure of account to be exempted from income tax. Means we would completely remove all the amount and close the account. There will be no taxation, no income tax. Then expansion of women's self-help groups interest rate subvention program to all districts. Then 1 lakh loan under Mudra scheme for one woman in every self-help group. Then 8 crore more free LPG connections to be given under Ujjwala Yojana. Labor laws to be rationalized into 4 labor codes. And in industry, the changes made are 1. Minimum public shareholding in listed companies to be increased from 25 to 35%. 100% FDI to be permitted for insurance intermediaries. Local sourcing norms to be eased for FDI in single brand retail. And in infrastructure, to expand Swachh Bharat mission to undertake solid waste management in all villages. And 70,000 crore fresh recapitalization to public sector banks. And RBI will be the regulatory authority for housing finance sector. So these are the gist or the key points in the budget. We will see the detailed coverage too. A detailed budget video would also be uploaded. So inside also we can see some of the provisions in the budget. One is budget proposes higher income tax on rich. Government eases angel tax norms. RBI can supersede non-banking finance company board, like we saw for the housing finance sector. And PPP route, public-private partnership route for railway modernization. And Air India sell-off back on agenda. So this is the budget coverage on taxes. As we saw, budget proposes higher income tax on rich. So as we have seen, the surcharge on taxable income has been increased for people in the 2 to 5 crore bracket. It has been increased by 3%, and for 5 crore and above, it has been increased by 7%. So here you can see. So direct tax revenue has increased by over 78% to 11.37 lakh crores in the last 5 years. But it is now growing in double digits every year. So here you can see the inflation trends shown and the lending rates. So this is weighted average lending rates of scheduled commercial banks. So lending rates are falling, inflation you can see. It has gone high and now taken a dip. So after retail inflation fell from 6% to 1.4%, the lending rates in scheduled commercial banks too dipped correspondingly. So this is the taxation details you can see. Then here you have petrol diesel levies hiked by rupees 2 per litre. So actually there is a duty imposed on petrol and a cess too. So the taxation rate, the duty has been increased by 1 rupee per litre and cess has also been increased by 1 rupee per litre. So effectively 2 rupees per litre hike on both petrol and diesel has been announced. And below you have Aadhaar can be interchanged with PAN for filing tax returns. So making Aadhaar interchangeable with PAN for taxation filing has been announced in the budget. Also, there is a plan to give the Aadhaar number expeditiously to visiting NRIs also. Then on page 3 you have this coverage. It is said investors who file requisite declaration won't be subject to any scrutiny in respect of valuation of share premiums. So the angel tax norms have been eased by the government for the startups in the budget. And here you can see this is the graphical coverage given on GVA growth rate, gross value added growth rate for agriculture and allied sectors. So this is agriculture and allied sectors, that is forestry, fisheries, then for industry, then for services in green, and blue shows the overall growth rate. So that's over the last 3 years, 4 years. Then micro, small and medium enterprises hail move to raise corporate tax limit. So corporate income tax of 25% is going to be levied on businesses with turnover up to rupees 400 crore. So earlier the limit was of annual turnover of rupees 250 crores. So now more enterprises would be coming under it. So it is actually micro, small and medium enterprises which would be benefited. So it says this will cover 99.3% of the companies. So now only 0.7% of the companies will remain outside this 25% tax rate. And this is government slaps 10% customs duty on newsprint. So import duty on newsprint has been announced by the government of 10% and import duty on printed books of 5%. You should know there was no import duty on newsprint so far, but now it has been announced. And there's a coverage here, will budget boost the investment rate? So this covers how the government proposes to develop India into $5 trillion economy by 2024-25. So that depends on real growth rate and inflation should remain under control. And movement of Indian rupee vis-a-vis the US dollar, how does it go? So all these factors are going to decide whether we achieve the $5 trillion economy target. So there are a number of provisions in the budget, it is said, which promote growth promoting initiatives as they are called. So they are listed down here. You can see first, government proposes to access global investors by floating sovereign bonds denominated in external currency. Second, government has come out with a clearer focus on Make in India. And third, provisions for micro, small and medium enterprises, startups, automobiles, electronics, defense manufacturing. So that is Make in India. Then third, the government aims to invite global investors for setting up mega manufacturing plants to bring advanced technology in electric vehicles, electronics and other related areas. Fourth, it says the burden of non-performing assets on banking sector is likely to ease with the budgeted capital infusion of 70,000 crores for public sector banks. So these are some of the four key provisions which have been listed down, which are going to boost growth as such in the country. Then this is fiscal deficit target revised downwards to 3.3%. So rating agencies and analysts say that there is a risk of missing the 3.3% target if tax revenue is not up to the mark. So fiscal deficit target for 2019-20, earlier it was 3.4% of GDP, it has been brought down to 3.3% of GDP. So means government cannot take a lot of borrowing, means the government borrowing has been limited. So that's a good step. Then this is the entire detail of the budget, the allocation being done in the budget. So you can see defense allocation has been up by 6.9% now. You can see a maximum chunk of the total budget goes in interest payment. So government takes loans and on that they have to pay the interest. So interest payment, you can see the rates are also given. Blue shows the rate earlier and yellow shows the rate in the present budget. So interest payment, one aspect. Then second is, and the figure here shows the amount as such in 1000 crores. Then this is second chunk, major chunk is defense. So you can see defense allocation. Then next is subsidies. Within subsidies also you can see food subsidy, fertilizer subsidy and petroleum subsidy shown. Then this is pensions. So the pension payments which the government undertakes to public employees. Transportation, agriculture, then transfer to states, rural development, tax administration and other affairs. You can see home, education, health, science, urban development, etc. The budget allocation is shown here. So defense expenditure has been increased compared to previous year. And agriculture allocation has also been increased by 75% in the present budget. That means budget allocation last year was 3,500 crores. It has now been increased to 5,400 crores. So that is a 75% increase. Then above also you have coverage on agriculture. You can see it says APMC Act should not hamper farmers from getting a fair price. So this is agriculture produce marketing committees. So there are these APMC agriculture markets, agriculture mandis markets as such, where the farmers sell their produce, and there are APMC acts which state governments have enacted because agriculture is a state subject. So these acts have conditions which actually affect farmers getting a fair price. So the middleman role comes here in the markets as such too. So it says that farmers should get a fair price and ease of doing business should apply to them too. So again, middlemen being eliminated if direct purchase takes place by big companies, corporates, you can see in the agriculture sector too, then also like FMCG and other entities, then also it is said as raw material they would require agricultural produce. So concerns still would be there. So how farmers would get fair price, that cannot be left to the private sector. So government intervention would be required. But APMC acts require modification, it requires amendments. And this is unequal distribution. So regarding agriculture credit disbursed and loan disbursed to small farmers and marginal farmers. So after overall agriculture credit disbursed, you can see amount disbursed to small and marginal farmers is shown. So it says only 50% of total agriculture credit disbursed went to small farmers and marginal farmers. So this trend was the same. So the total land holdings in India, you can see share of small and marginal farmers is 85%. So 85% farmers in the country are small and marginal farmers, but in agricultural credit which they get, only 50% of the total agriculture credit goes to these 85% farmers. So means bigger agricultural entities, farmers are taking over agriculture credit benefit too. Then below you have slew of steps to boost digital payments. So before that, here also you have a coverage laying the base for spurring investment. Again, this is regarding how the regulatory oversight of non-banking finance companies and housing finance companies has to be strengthened to benefit all stakeholders. So now RBI has given this mandate too. And here you have slew of steps to boost digital payment. So the finance minister has proposed tax on cash withdrawals exceeding rupees 1 crore in a year. So this will be for cash withdrawals. So this is going to boost digital payments. And if there are any such cash transactions taking place, then there will be a TDS, tax deduction at source of 2% on such cash withdrawals. And then this is 1.05 lakh crore is disinvestment target. So government may reduce its direct majority stake in some companies to below 51% mark, as has been announced in the as has been suggested in the economic survey too, that government to stick to 51% mark can be done through say 40% by government and 11% by LIC. So that's also public company, so it's respectively 51%. So government may reduce its direct majority stake in some companies. Then on page 5, you have another quote by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman with respect to agriculture. So there is value addition to farmer produce which can be done, and for this private entrepreneurship will be supported by the government, infrastructure will be invested in. So this has been announced by the Finance Minister. Then this is regarding personal income tax collection and its annual growth rate shown here over the entire years from 2001 onwards. So how you can see there has been an increase in personal income tax collection, but the growth rate as such is, you can see, shown. It had taken a dip in 2009-10 and then it has again taken a dip here in 2014-15. and now it's steadily rising. So this is percentage growth in collection. Then this is what we have already done. RBI can supersede non-banking finance company boards. It was there on front page. So RBI will now also regulate housing finance companies which are under National Housing Board's purview. So this has already been taken up by RBI. Now budget also mentions it. And this is growth capital for public sector banks. So government has decided to infuse 70,000 crores in public sector banks now. So that is going to, you know, recapitalize them and help in reducing their NPA burden, non-performing assets burden. Then for micro, small and medium enterprises, there is already corporate tax which has been reduced, which is going to benefit them, 25% corporate tax. Plus also the other provisions you can see here for MSMEs. So they will get a 2% interest subvention scheme. So this is to promote Make in India. So you can see this will be for GST registered MSMEs on fresh or incremental loans. So 350 crore rupees has been allotted for this in the budget. Then another one, the provision announced for MSMEs is that they would get loan up to rupees 1 crore within 59 minutes through a dedicated online portal. So this is also a scheme announced by the budget. So you can see this is another scheme, is scheme for a fund for upgradation and regeneration of traditional industries, Sphurti. So under this scheme, 100 new clusters will be set up in 2019-20, enabling 50,000 artisans to join economic value chain. So this is a scheme called Phurti. Another scheme mentioned here is Pradhan Mantri Karam Yogi Mandhan scheme. So this is a scheme under which you can see pension would be provided, pension benefit to retail traders and small shopkeepers whose annual turnover is less than 1.5 crore rupees. So this is going to benefit about 3 crore retail traders and small shopkeepers. This is there. Then also another announcement is to create a payment platform for MSMEs to enable filing of bills and payments on the platform itself to eliminate delays in government payments. Then on page 6 you have another quote. Our economy was about a 1.85 trillion when we formed the government in 2014. In 5 years it has reached 2.7 trillion. So of course there will be a growth in the economy. Economy is going to expand and there is a growth, but if the percentage growth higher than normal is what has to be seen, not in absolute terms. So here this is a coverage on number of taxpayers and tax payable. So who pays what is shown here. The majority of taxpayers in the country, you can see, have an income below 2.5 lakh. So they fall in this bracket. And here you can see the amount of tax which is paid by them. This is number shown by the bar and the drop dot shows amount of tax paid by them. So there are only 5 lakh taxpayers with an income over 10 lakh rupees, 10 lakh per annum. So the highest amount of tax payables come from those in this slab, you can see. So this dot lies here. So this is regarding taxation. How much amount is collected through these taxpayers in this slab is around 5,000 crores. In this slab also it's almost the same, but in this slab it's near 500,000 crores. Then this is on agriculture. It says zero budget for farmers, no drought relief. So farmers say the government has ignored their concerns. So the budget has no provision for them is what is the farmers feel. So farmers are going to win the benefit of minimum support price that has been announced, the PM Asha scheme, in which there is a guaranteed procurement at the minimum support price rates provided to the farmers. So this is been implemented, but of course all farmers cannot be covered, all crops cannot be covered in the first, in the present scheme as such. Is there? Then this is the coverage on the growth in the agriculture sector. How the growth in the agriculture sector, you can see this is the growth shown in this, with this line, black line, and the blue line shows total gross value addition at basic prices. So how the growth has been over the years. So the growth had fallen significantly earlier in 2014-15 and now again in 2018-19. So kharif sowing this season has also been affected because of delayed monsoon, so crisis has deepened. Then below you have Precious metals set to get dearer. So government has hiked import duty on gold, silver and platinum from 10% to 12.5%. And for disaster management, budget allocation is up by 5% with special focus on cyber crime. So you can see this is important because disaster management is also a topic in mains in UPSC. Then on page 7 here, a quote given is, the right time is right for India to enter aviation finance and leasing. Connectivity is at the heart of development. So that is for infrastructure. So here you can see this is the coverage given on vehicles. Sale of passenger and commercial vehicles. It has fallen sharply. You can see from 2018 to 2019. So the sale of commercial vehicles has also dropped significantly. So that is the coverage given here. And this is minimum public holding raised for listed firms. So center has moved a social stock exchange. So there'll be this idea of social stock exchange will come under the regulatory purview of SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, which has been announced. So the minister has announced. So it is time to take our capital market closer to the masses and meet various social welfare objectives related to inclusive growth and financial inclusion. So for this, the finance minister has proposed creating an electronic fundraising platform called a social stock exchange. So it will be under the regulatory oversight of SEBI, and it would be for listing social entities and voluntary organizations working towards social welfare objectives so that they could raise capital as equity, debt or as units like a mutual fund. Then below you have simpler securities transaction tax cheers derivative traders. So this is regarding the securities transaction tax which is levied on such derivative traders when they have transactions done. So this has been tweaked, making it more attractive for market participants. So STT is now restricted only to difference between settlement and strike price in case of exercise of options. So there are futures and options provisions. So this is regarding securities transaction tax, which is paid at 0.125% of settlement price. So this will now be only for the difference. And if the option is not exercised, then securities transaction tax is 0.05% of the premium. Then below you have KYC norms for foreign portfolio investors to be investor friendly. So, foreign investment is a key source of capital in the economy. So, government is planning to take all possible steps to encourage more foreign investment in the country. So, such investors, when they come to India, they will be able to invest in a hassle-free manner. So, for that, know your customer norms have been made investor-friendly. And this is what we discussed on the previous page. We propose to initiate steps to create a social stock exchange for listing social enterprises, so that they can raise capital. And this is regarding, you can see, infrastructure. So 30 kilometers of roads have been laid every day in 2018-19 compared to 12 kilometers in 2014-15. So the length of construction of national highways and roads is shown here. You can see construction of roads in kilometers and in per day as such in kilometers has been shown. And this is making a pitch for public-private partnership model in railways. So transporter, that is railways, gets the highest ever allocation of 1.6 lakh crores. And minister says that about 50 lakh crore will be required for the railways till 2030. So even public-private partnership is proposed to modernize the railways. And this is the Vande Bharat Express, India's first semi-high-speed train, which is under Make in India. Then this is regarding how, you know, railways has been faring, the performance targets for it. So here you can see details given. Then this is regarding the tax benefits for electric vehicles. So the main objective of the FAME scheme, faster adoption of e-vehicles as such, manufacturing of e-vehicles. So this scheme is to encourage faster adoption of electric vehicles. So this is also mentioned here, you can see. The custom duty exemption has been provided on certain parts of electric vehicles, and also you can see other income tax exemptions are also there of 1.5 lakh rupees to vehicle buyers. So this is additional income tax exemption. and India is proposed to be made into a manufacturing hub for electric vehicles. 1.5 lakh income tax deduction on interest paid on loans can be taken as a benefit for purchasing electric vehicles, and additional income tax benefit is also provided. And this is how even GST on electric vehicles have been reduced from 12% to 5%. Then on page 9 you have on infrastructure, the finance minister says we plan to use public right partnership for faster development and completion of tracks and rolling stock manufacturing. And this is the budget allocation for education and health shown here, how it has remained stagnant also presently. So this is their education allocation is around 3.5% and health around 2% of GDP. Then here you have Air India disinvestment set to take off again. So FDI norms have been eased for aviation sector, but it is unlikely to benefit it because the concerns are of ownership, because majority stake lies with an Indian owner. So the issue of ownership does not attract FDI, ownership and control issue. And Air India disinvestment will also be tried once again now. The Udaan scheme is also mentioned here. Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik scheme, which aims to take air travel to the masses and bring in connectivity between Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities. Then this is regarding defense expenditure too shown here, how defense expenditure has, the percentage of total expenditure, how it has fallen, means from around 3%, a little above 3% to now 2.25%. And this is regarding India's allocation to defense expenditure over the years and its comparison with other countries. So when India's defense allocation, military expenditure is 2.4% of GDP, highest is of Pakistan at 4% of GDP. US is also lesser than Pakistan, it is at 3.2% of GDP, though India's is 2.4 lies below USA. China has very low budget expenditure, that is of 1.9% of its GDP. And this is regarding buying. India being a significant arms importer, you can see India's arms imports are quite high. 1,539,000 million. This amount in millions shown. So China is the maximum arms importer, you can see, at a major buying spree. And US of course will be significantly less. It does not import arms, it manufactures its own arms. Then this is ambitious plans for aviation. So realizing MRO. MRO stands for maintenance, repair and overhaul. So we are developing India into an MRO hub is being proposed as such. And here you have interlinking of highways through a grid proposed. So connecting ports, cities and tourist spots is being proposed in the budget. Here you can see the Bharatmala phase 2 will also be there, which will see national highways being connected to state highways. So working with state governments to develop state highways will also be undertaken. The first phase of Bharatmala has laid a total of 34,800 km of road. And this is call for port-led development. So this is emphasis on using inland waterways to move cargo. So this is the Sagarmala project. So there is Bharatmala project, there is Sagarmala project for port connectivity. So you should know about it. Then another quote given is the government is proposing to streamline multiple labor laws into a set of 4 labor codes. So this was there also on the front page. And this is regarding rate of unemployment. So you can see the rate of unemployment for males and females is shown here. Females, the rate of urban female and urban male unemployment rate has been shown. And this is 3 language formula takes the cake in outlay. So 50 crore rupees has been allotted for appointing Hindi teachers in non-Hindi speaking states. So this scheme is to aid teachers of Urdu and other languages. So budget allocation for 3 language formula is there in the present budget announced. And this is regarding various social schemes, regarding school education, higher education, MGNREGS, rural development and social welfare schemes. The allocation is shown here. The allocation for MGNREGS has dropped, you can see. Rural development has dropped. Higher education has slightly increased. school education has come down and social welfare has, provisions have also been brought down. So everything has dropped except higher education. Then this is opening the funds tab for water scheme. So no specific funds have been announced, but the Jal Jeevan mission as such, which is promising piped water supply to all rural households by 2024. So there is no budget allocation of its own under it. Then even funds for National Ganga Plan and Ghats work has seen a sharp fall from last year. Then below you have a big step in tax transparency. So this is how Aadhaar and PAN have been made interchangeable for filing tax returns. And this is Gandhipedia to sensitize society. So the budget also announces, the finance minister announced in her budget speech that Gandhipedia is being developed in order to sensitize society, particularly the youth, about Gandhian values. So it will be 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. So that, there will be several programs for it throughout the year. So in 2019, so an encyclopedia like Gandhipedia would be one of the first initiatives which are being taken by the government. Then on the last page on budget, you have here, by 2022, every rural family except those unwilling to take the connection will have electricity and clean cooking facility. So here you can see the groundwork for affordable rural houses has also been announced. So tax deductions for interest paid on loans for houses up to rupees 45 lakh has been increased. So plans are to build 1.95 crore rural houses now. Then this is regarding subsidies. So how much subsidies payment government has to incur. This is the revenue expenditure of the government. There are two sides to the expenditure, like two aspects, capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. So the revenue expenditure components, the most highest allocation is for interest payments. So when loans are taken by the government, interest has to be paid. So that is interest payment. Then salaries and pensions being paid by the government, and this is also revenue expenditure, and this is subsidies. So major subsidies are food, fertilizer and petroleum subsidies. So this is regarding their percentage of GDP. So here over the years also you can see the food subsidy has gone down. Fertilizer subsidy has almost remained the same over the last few years. And this is the last one is petroleum subsidy, which has been significantly brought down compared to 2013-14. And here you can see how it, assistance has been dropped. It's in the negative now for food subsidy. So revenue expenditure has declined by 1.7% of GDP, and this is because of dip in subsidies. So change in major subsidies compared to 2013-14 is shown here. Then below you have regarding health sector, there's no fresh announcements, although allocations for health have been hiked. And this is Bhutan gains, Chabahar loses in budget pile. So Nepal and Mauritius get high priority in funds allotted, while Afghanistan's funding has come down. So in the budget, we also make provisions for such neighboring countries as such too, the assistance which will be provided. So India's building activities, the crucial Chabahar port which has been built in Iran, so for that the allocation has dropped. So 45 crore rupees has been allotted here, which is a significant reduction compared to previous year's allocation of 150 crore rupees. So Chabahar in Iran, the drop has been seen there, and the hike has been seen, substantial hike in the allocation for Bhutan, which is one of the closest neighbors of India. And also you can see Nepal, Mauritius get high priority in funding. Plus, Afghanistan's location has also been brought down. Then here you have women-led initiatives and child protection services get a boost. So, government has announced setting up a committee to assess budgetary allocation through a gender lens. So, that means gender budgeting as it is required. So, this would be done now. So, panel will be set up to assess budget through a gender lens. So, that was the coverage on budget. Here the editorial, the first editorial is bucks for the banks. So the union budget is hoping to spur economy to revitalize the financial sector. So this talks about the budget as such. It's a complete editorial on the budget, that's very important. Then this is falling far short of the goal. So it says the rhetoric in the budget of accelerated, inclusive and sustainable development receives only limited financial backing. So there are no drastic changes in the budget, but incremental changes announced. And this is choosing the long view. So this says the budget is part of the long-term creation of New India and continues with the vision of the previous tenure. Then on the op-ed page here you have again budget coverage, searching for reform signals. So it says while the budget shows commitment to fiscal consolidation, there are very few measures that can steer the economy to acceleration. And again, this is a budget that goes nowhere. So again, a coverage on budget. And this article says the macro does not gel with micro. So it says the budget describes with admirable practicality what we would like to see in India, but it is not convincing on how we can have the growth to afford the same. On international page you have this: Sri Lanka's Supreme Court stays execution of drug offense convicts. So this is an issue which had created furor as such when Sri Lanka announced death sentence for drug related offenses, and that sentence was awarded to few convicts and the president had also approved them, but now the Supreme Court of Sri Lanka has stayed this execution. So the 43-year-old moratorium on capital punishment, that is death sentence of Sri Lanka, was being breached, but now this order has been stayed. So that is it. There's no news coverage on the last page. So these are the important news items from today's newspaper. Thank you.